Hello, this is Muhammad Hanif from RGKT Basel. Once again, I welcome you to the new session on this MATLAB. And the subject we are dealing is a digital signal processing lab. So today, we'll be seeing how we can design a filter using some commands in MATLAB. Okay, so we have two different approaches we can go to design a filter. One is using a commands, another is a special tool offered by MATLAB, so that is filter designer tool. Okay, so today we'll be seeing how we can design the filter using a commands. So for that one, I will be designing a low pass FIR filter today. So let's start. So first is CLC and clear all, close all. Now first we will be defining one sampling frequency, say 4000. So this is our sampling frequency. Okay, sampling frequency, and then we'll define sampling rate, that is 1/FS. Okay, this is our sampling rate, and then we'll define time period for a sequence. So let's start with 0, and then with the interval of TS, it goes up to 1 minus TS. Okay, so now next we'll define one signal, say S. This is sine of 2 into pi into, and having some frequency, so taking only 10 frequency here with the T. So it is generating a sine wave with a frequency of 10 hertz. Okay, and next we'll be generating a noise signal, which later on we'll going to add to this X, so that we'll have one high frequency signal overlapped with this sine wave, so that we can do filtering on that particular signal. Okay, so now we'll be generating one noise signal, say in N. So this will be like a random signal, so 0.5 into rand N of a size T. So here this is what we're doing, is generating a noise signal, right? And then we'll add this signal, like Xn is having X plus N. Okay, so this will adding X, adding a sine wave and noise signal. Now this Xn is having completely noise signal. Okay, it is overlapped with noise signal. So what we do here, from here we'll try to plot this X, and say we'll give name as the figure one. Okay, and then so here we'll do, this is a figure two and this is XM. Okay, so we'll run the program up to here so that we can see how we have generated the signals. So here you can see that this is a figure one. So this is figure one is having a sine wave signal, sampling frequency of 400, and then you can see the frequency is 10. Okay, 10 means we will get 10 cycles here. Okay, and then this is noise signal. So here a high frequency signal is overlapped with our main frequency X. Now Now we have to design a filter, say D is equals to, so we have to, this is the command we have to use for designing filter. So here there are some specifications we have to maintain as we are planning to design low pass FIR filter. So we'll write that as here, and then so first we have to write a filter order. Okay, so filter order say 10, and then we have to mention cutoff frequency. Okay, cutoff frequency is, so cutoff frequency has to be more than our signal frequency. So it is 10 here. So let's, we'll go with, you can go with 10 also. It's better, we'll go with 20. Okay, you can use 10 also. Okay, so I'm using 20 here, and then a sample rate. So sample rate is nothing but here, we have to mention the sampling frequency. So sampling frequency is assigned to FS, so we'll write FS here. Okay, so that's it. And then writing this one using this design field, it will design a filter with these specifications, and those filter coefficients will be assigned to D. Okay, and now we'll write F out, that is filter output. Filter output will, we have to call a filter, and then we say this coefficients D, which is having filter coefficients, and then followed by this Xn, where Xn is having so noise signal overlap on this sign. So this is, Xn is having a high frequency signals superimposed on X. Okay, so now, so if you run this, we are going to get filter output. So here we'll write figure 3, and then we'll write, try to plot F out. Okay, now if we run this program, we must get filter design. So here you can see, so this is original signal, and this is our noise generator signal, and here it is filtered output. So now here you can see, though it is filtered some part of signal, but still it is not perfect. So we can improve this signal or improve the filtering by increasing this filter order. Okay, so let's, we'll increase the filter order here. Say you can 51. Now once again we'll run this program. Now we'll once again this one. So here you can see that as a filter order is increased, you can see that there is some improvement in this. So still we can improve by increasing this order. Okay, so we can get a new or even we can reduce this cutoff frequency also. Okay, so these are the methods we can design any frequency with specifications. So even in this one, by adding window and by adding design method, we can design window techniques like a rectangular window or Kaiser window, Hamming window, that we have to add here. So for this one, we can go with help design FALT. So it will give us a documentation related to our this design field. So this is the design field documentation. Here you can see what we can do with FIR filter or IR filter. So here you can see that for FIR filter, low pass FIR, and then pass band frequency, where we have to mention the pass band frequency and stop band. Here you can see that it is asking for design method. So in this design method, if you are using any windowing technique, then we have to write that window name also. Okay, so I hope you have understand this. Okay, so thank you.